Let's start with some math. 30,635 people applied for elk licenses in Pennsylvania in 2016. Only 124 people got one. The odds are dismal. But the fact that Pennsylvania's elk season happens at all has always been a long shot. By 1867, settlers wiped out the native elk population. In 1913, the Pennsylvania Game Commission reintroduced the animal. Today, there are more than 1,000 elk roaming an 800-square-mile section of the Commonwealth. The epicenter of the resurgence is Benazet. It's opening day, and Gary Fritz is one of the lucky few. He's entered the elk hunt lottery 14 of the past 15 years. This year, he finally got a shot, and he took it. Fritz is one of just 10 hunters to bag a bull on the first day. Some of you may be wondering, why hunt an animal with a history of population problems? But this is more than sport, it's biology.
This is our annual check station. It's held during every day of the hunting season. It's a mandatory check station. If you harvest an elk in Pennsylvania, you have to come through the check station within 24 hours.
The first component of the check station is law enforcement.
Wait, 548, right?
Conservation officers want to know where the elk was killed and who killed it. After that, the scientists go to work on the second component, health monitoring. First, the basics.
We take a tooth for an age. So the tooth is removed, a central incisor is removed. It's sliced microscopic thin, put on a slide, stained, and then essentially with every year of life, a layer of cementum is added to the tooth, and you can kind of count those up at like you would count the rings in a tree.
Then some smaller samples that could reveal much larger problems. Blood is drawn and tested for disease. A small slice of the tongue is used for DNA. The lungs are examined for tuberculosis. The brainstem and lymph nodes are tested for chronic wasting disease, a contagious neurological disease present in the white-tailed deer population in southern Pennsylvania.
We're trying to make sure that the animals have a good genetic diversity so that when they get chronic wasting disease, and unfortunately it will happen eventually, we can tell that, you know, they're going to be as genetically diverse as possible to combat the disease as much as they can.
After the outdoor lab, the antlers are measured and scored, and the bulls in Pennsylvania have been impressive.
It's a good indication of how the animals are doing. Everything, the thickness, all that is a real good indication of good health of the herd, okay? And plus two, what happens is we will get ages. So obviously this looks great. Size, everything is great. When we get the age back, again, it gives us a real good indication. Some of these are only reached 5 or 6 years old. They're not even in their prime yet.
It's a sign of a comeback nearly 100 years in the making. One made possible by a culture of conservation at the Game Commission and in the hunting community.
I think it's very important. I mean, it's part of nature to watch the cycle of nature take place, and no place better than in Pennsylvania on a day like today.